Hey guys, welcome back to more AFK Arena. In today's video, we're going to do the maxed out Awakened Solace. We are completely maxed on this one with engravings, signature item, technically furniture. You could say that we're not all the dupes on furniture, but hey, we're pretty close. We got the tier 4 gear and everything over here on Kiasma's account. Now, I want to have a quick chat about Solace first because you guys know I absolutely love her in the early game. The problem with Solace into the late game is that honestly, I'm fine, like, and this is just my personal early testing here on Kiasma, is that I find her to be more of a tank than anything else in her purpose. The problem that I find when you get to high deficits in late game is that her healing is insane, but that healing doesn't really matter as much, just due to the fact that, you know, things always just get one shot. So like her healing is insane levels, but it's often the fact that even though it's at insane levels, like if things getting one shot, there's nothing it can do. So that's the interesting thing. However, with her extra lives, with the way she keeps herself topped off, she's and her buffs, she's actually a really decent. I normally just place her in the front row, and where I've been liking her is in like either like Kren or Raku teams, because those two like take time, and having them guarded behind her, she's actually a really solid. And I don't know if anyone else is finding this, but I'm finding her to be a really solid tank. And she also provides that sustain if you're using other tanky units on the team. I often find her useful with something like a Gorvo, because Gorvo's got the shields. You know, he can take some damage, but keep himself alive with those shields, and then she can top him off. A character I would love them to invent in the game would be a character who's like, has a passive that's like, can't lose more than 20% of max health every second. Then Solace would synergize so well and away we go. It'd be sick. But until then, this is basically, I'll show you where I'm finding her useful. Let me know any other teams you guys like. I am still really liking Awakened Solace. Brutus probably has more utility in the end game at this stage from testing, but Solace, a really solid unit nonetheless. Taylene's another solid one as well. Obviously, they're all pretty decent, actually. Like, none of the Awakens are horrible, but none of them are like straight. To be fair, I really like Thane if you max him out. But let's just look here. So this is the first team I want to show you guys. This is basically in a Raku Da Vinci team. And in this one, I'm just using her to tank in front of Raku and Da Vinci. And that's pretty much the purpose of this. Mishka's in there to get the stuns on. And basically, you probably sub out Mishka, but she actually does pretty good in this one. Her both, like one wolf dies, she jumps, and then the next one, then she jumps. So let's take a look. The deficit is that we're at 825, they're at 1152. So we're at a 327 level deficit in this one. So let's go ahead and take a look. I'll show you this one, and then we'll experiment with some other stuff. So honestly, this team's not too threatening. As you can see, Mishka does an early jump there. Got to jump straight into another one, which is really solid. And Raku can just absolutely shred from this point. But as you can see, that Solace just sits in the front row there. Obviously, we don't have too much heat on her, but she just has no issues. And then she can go ahead there and heal. Now, the problem we'll find with Mishka is that she just sort of, you know, gets clapped. But, you know, these things happen. But we do have the CC there. I can't remember what she dies to. Maybe she dies. Oh, no, she dies to a Tharin. Yeah, that doesn't matter. So yeah, like she has that effect where she can keep things alive, she can tank, just all round solid. There you go. Mishka gets one shot by the Tharin, doesn't really matter, we end up getting the kill. So that's where I've been liking her the most. Like I said, front row seems to be my most enjoyable position. I've been in testing, like I've been doing some battles where the whole team dies and she's still left there on the front row just like channeling. So honestly, it's pretty decent, her tankiness. So let's go ahead, let's try. Like I said, the other thing that I do like is going to be like Raku-based teams and Kren-based teams. So let's go ahead and try the Kren, see what we can do. Now, the problem with Kren, once again, is always that you want the longbow so they can deal the extra damage, but he often commits suicide. So sometimes you have to put the Shroud of Verdure. I don't know if his dress looks like a cape, I guess. Anyway, let's go with that. We'll go with the Brutus. Let's actually do it against... we'll leave it against this team. We can just do it like that. Put him there. Who else do we want to bring into this team? The rest is sort of... I feel like she can just tank it for him. You know, let's put a random Anarchy in there for fun. Actually, let's put you in there. Actually, I really like him as a tank. I really like his versatility. I've been using him a bit more. I can't even remember his name, but Kringle one shot, rip. Okay. So let's do him up there. Let's do you there. This should be okay. We'll see what happens. Oh, we're gonna waste our knockback on the Wukong. Okay, I'll set it up and I'll be back. So I'm just running some testing, but this one I just want to show you guys because it's a prime example of what I was mentioning with her, and like the whole team will die and she'll just sit there and not die. Now, we didn't get Kren to do an ultimate, so obviously he's done zero damage in this battle. But when you compare it to the damage that the enemy teams have dealt, it's still not too bad damage. Obviously, if Kren ults and deletes the whole team, he's probably going to be about 2 to 3 times her damage. But like the damage taken here, she's taken so much damage, done so much healing, and she's just the last one living. It's just like, I didn't cancel it. So yeah, just wanted to demonstrate this of like, she just has really good staying power. It's just a matter of getting, you know, the team to survive. You can see Kren sitting down there. We almost got Kren to survive. Problem is, he got towards his second pushback and he runs forward and gets himself killed. But, you know, she can take a fair bit of damage, which is really, really solid in my opinion. Anyway, I'll get a victory and we'll be back. Okay, so here we go. Here's the Kren example. And this team is literally all about enabling one win condition, and that is the Kren. Like that's all this team wants to do. We've got Skreg in here, obviously tanking the Solas to one be a tank in the front row, also to keep anyone alive that she can. Gorvo flops pretty early in this one, but she does help the Skreg. She actually synergizes pretty well with Skreg in my opinion in these type of comps. Like I like her Skreg and Kren in a team, because you know Skreg, he gets the damage mitigation as he stomps through enemies. He also knocks them back into Kren's bombs. They just have that good synergy, and because he's getting the mitigated damage, sometimes she can keep him topped off and stop him from getting one shot. Then like obviously just to speed it up, and Gorvo's just there for some interruption, and we just want Kren to win. So the interesting thing about this matchup is that it does have an Aziz, which is actually like a bad matchup for this because it can cancel the ult. I'm pretty sure if we watch this replay, I'm pretty sure it cancels the ult as well. But the great thing is, like, at these deficits, Mezoth's chop at the start of a battle like normally one shots anything, but she can live through it. That's the cool thing. So here we go, doing the ult, and I'm waiting to see if one of them do an ultimate. Yeah, so I'm not sure if there was enough direct attacks or whether it was, because I didn't think she took that many direct attacks, because once she takes X amount, this is the one bad thing about her in the front row. Once she takes, I think it's 9 direct attacks, she will stop channeling. So there she goes. She stopped again, and I don't think she had that many. So I believe the Aziz interrupts it. But still, like she's just sitting there in front of that Mezoth, who normally just like one shots dudes, and she's just tanking it like it ain't no thing. But she does eventually die, so bear with me here, but like she does the job that she needed to do. Like she enables this whole thing, and so we did get that. We luckily got the Mezoth below 50%. Lyca's gonna ult here and knock him back into range of the bombs. Honestly, there's a lot of lucky RNG at the end there after Solas died, but you know the whole principle is that is where that's the main place that I'm looking at Awakened Solas in the late/endgame at these higher sorts of deficits. I feel like that's where she really has the usefulness as front row. Honestly, 2 extra lives, like it's kind of like Brutus, the extra lives, it's valuable. But she does have a lot of buffing potential and stuff like that on top of it. You know, she can animate her allies. I just think she's pretty decent. Like, she's not god tier at this end game. She's god tier in the early game. If you get a legendary copy of her in the first like 25 chapters, she can be god tier, even at legendary. But you know, this stage of the game, not crazy. I still absolutely love her. She's my favorite one at the moment. My favorite awakened hero. I know her design's not that crazy, but I just like it. I think I just like the water tails, the whole reasoning behind giving her water tails and stuff like that. So that is going to be Solas. At the end there, I did put her on Juru's Call. I think she works really well in Juru's Call. If not, you can use anything, Tidebearer, Oceanic String, stuff like that. But Juru's Call to get that ult faster if you need it. But in the late game, sort of loses its effectiveness a little bit, but still pretty solid. Anyway, guys, that is it for the maxed out Solas. Let me know what you guys think. Have you got any other teams that you've been pushing with her? I'm keen to test, but at the moment, I really like her in those setup-based teams where you got one key win condition, and it's about getting through the longer battle to make them do that, mainly being Raku and Kren. Also, I am biased towards Raku and Kren because I love those characters, so I'm always going to try and make them work more. So let me know your guys' guys' ideas. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you have an awesome day, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next one. Cheers.